In this video, we will understand how to analyze the financial statement of a company with the help of fund flow, or we can say how to prepare the fund flow statement. That is what we are going to understand in this video, or with the help of this video. So let's start. There are four steps which we have to follow for preparing a fund flow statement. And that the first one is statement of change in working capital. Second, adjusted profit and loss account. Third, fund flow statement. And fourth step, we will have to open all the account, ledger account on which there is an adjustment. So these are the four steps which we will have to follow while preparing fund flow statement, right? So let us go for the first step, statement of change in working capital. Let us try to understand how to prepare the statement of change in working capital. But before that, let us understand the concept of working capital and the effect of current asset and current liability on the working capital. So here the heading is effect of working capital in fund flow statement. Now, why we are trying to understand this effect, the effect of working capital in fund flow statement? Because our first step is preparation of change in working capital, statement of change in working capital. So how working capital affects the flow of fund? That is what we will understand from this slide. Now, if you talk about working capital, how do we get working capital? Current asset minus current liability. So you can see current asset minus current liability will give you working capital. So let us assume if current asset is 10 and current liability is 8, so our working capital will be 2. Easy. Now let us try to increase the current asset. So you can see we have increased the current asset from 10 to 11. So if you increase your current asset from 10 to 11, your working capital will also increase from 2 to 3. So that means if you increase your current asset, your working capital will increase. Correct? Now let us try to decrease our current asset. Same thing you can see. If we decrease our current asset from 10 to 9, our working capital is also decreasing from 2 to 1. So it has been proved that if the current asset decreases, our working capital will also decrease. So in short, we can say there is a direct relationship between current asset and working capital. And that has been proved. If you increase your current asset, your working capital will increase. If you decrease your current asset, your working capital will decrease. Correct? Now let us discuss about current liability. Right now, current liability is 8. Let us try to increase the current liability. So we have increased the current liability, keeping current asset same, from 8 to 9, and thus we found that our working capital is decreasing. So that means if you increase your current liability, your working capital will decrease. And the last situation, if we decrease our current liability from 8 to 7, our working capital will increase. keeping current asset same. Hence, we can say that if current liability decreases, working capital will increase. Final conclusion, there is an inverse relationship between current liability and working capital. If you decrease your current liability, your working capital will increase. If you increase your current liability, your working capital will decrease. So there is an inverse relationship between current liability and working capital. So I guess till now you have understood the connection between current asset and working capital, or the connection between current liability and working capital. Finally, what is important for us is the connection between working capital and the flow of fund. Right? So what exactly is working capital? Working capital is the amount which you require for your day-to-day activities of the business. So if you want to pay salary, if you want to pay rent, if you want to spend on printing and stationery, so you will have to use this amount or utilize this amount from working capital. So that is why it is said that working capital is the amount which is required for the day-to-day activities of the business. Okay, now what will happen if the working capital increases? If the working capital increases, that means more and more amount is getting blocked into the business. Fine. So, which indicates funds are not coming in, funds are going out. So, if working capital increases, it indicates that funds are going out. Why? Because it is not in. How can we say that funds are going out? Because more and more amount of money is getting blocked in the business in form of working capital. Because this is the amount which we are going to use for our day-to-day activities of the business. Fine. Same way, if working capital decreases, then that means fund comes in and you are raising fund, or you're getting fund by decreasing the working capital. So let me explain you once again about the decrease in working capital. If there is a decrease in working capital, that means you are trying to control your cost or control your expenses. So lesser amount will be blocked in the business. That means fund comes in. This is one of the source of fund. And hence it is said decrease in working capital is one of the source of fund, wherein increase in working capital is the application of fund. So from this slide, only this part is very important, which you will have to remember. What is that? Increase in working capital that is equal to fund going out, and it's an application. So if fund goes out, it's an application. If fund comes in, it's a source. So we can say decrease in working capital is one of the source of fund. As we are trying to understand fund flow statement. So what do you mean by fund flow? The flow of fund. Fund coming in and fund going out. If fund is coming in, from where it is coming. And if fund is going out, then where it is going. That is what we are here to understand. So there is a connection between working capital and the fund flow. And what is that connection? If there is an increase in working capital, it's an application. And if there is a decrease in working capital, it's a source. So I hope you have understood about the effect of working capital in the fund flow statement. Now let us go and prepare the first step, that is statement of change in working capital. Let us understand how to prepare the statement of change in working capital. So this is how we will have to prepare statement of change in working capital. You will have five columns. In that, the first one will be particular, second column will be the first year or the opening year, you can say, or the previous year, you can say. And the third column will be second year, or you can say closing year, or you can say current year. And then you will have increase in working capital column and decrease in working capital column. This is how we will have to prepare the statement of change in working capital. Now, the moment we say statement of change in working capital, so we should know the working capital of year 1 and the working capital of year 2, then only we will come to know about the change in working capital. Now, if you want to know the working capital of year 1 and year 2, that means you will have to calculate the working capital of first year and second year. And how to calculate the working capital, how to get the working capital? Current asset minus current liability. So let us calculate the working capital of both the year. So in this, the first thing that you will take is current asset, and then you will take all the items which comes under current asset. All this information will be given in the question, so you will have to just copy from there. Now if you talk about cash in hand, let us assume the cash in hand of first year is 10,000 and the cash in hand of second year is 12,000. First year 10,000, second year 12,000. So by looking the information which is given to us, that is 10,000 and 12,000, we can say that cash in hand is increasing. Now, if cash in hand increases, that means current asset will increase. And if current asset increases, as we have learned just now, if current asset increases, working capital will also increase, because there is a direct relationship between current asset and working capital. Hence, you will have to write the difference, that is 2000 in increase in working capital column. So the difference of these two you will have to write in the increase in working capital. Why we are recording in the increase in working capital? Because cash in hand is increasing. So if cash in hand increases, current asset will increase. And if current asset increases, working capital will increase. Hence we have recorded 2000 under increase in working capital column. Same way, you can take any example. So here we have assumed that cash at bank has decreased. Hence, we have recorded in the decrease in working capital. Here we have assumed that debtor is increasing. Hence, we have recorded the difference in the increase in working capital column. Here we have assumed that marketable securities is increasing. Hence, we have recorded the difference of marketable securities under the increase in working capital column. Here we have assumed that bills receivable is decreasing. Here we have assumed that stock is increasing. Then next we have assumed prepaid expense decreasing. Now one thing which is important, which you should keep in mind, is that you should not find out the difference of the total of current asset. Why? Because individually we have found the difference of each and every item. Hence you are not supposed to find the difference of the total. Right? Now let us try to understand the current liability. You will give the heading current liability, under which you will transfer all the items of current liability. Now, as you know, there is an inverse relationship. This is a direct relationship in case of current asset and current liability, wherein there is an inverse relationship. Between current liability and working capital. So here we have assumed that creditor is increasing. And thus, we will have to record the difference in the decrease column. Why? Because there is an inverse relationship between current liability and working capital. If current liability decreases, working capital will increase. I hope you are getting the points which I am trying to explain you. All right. Next is bills payable. So here we have assumed that bills payable is decreasing. Hence, we have recorded the difference in the increase column. Then next we have assumed outstanding expenses are increasing. Hence, we have recorded the difference in the decrease column. Just opposite, inverse. Again, we will not find the difference of the total of current liability. Now, we have the current asset of both the year and current liability of both the year. If you want to know the working capital, then you will have to subtract current liability from current asset, that is A minus B. So, once you subtract current liability from current asset, you will get working capital of both the year. So, once you get the working capital of both the year, then you will come to know whether there is an increase in working capital or decrease in working capital. You will come to know about the change in the working capital. So, if there is an increase in working capital, here you will say net increase in working capital in the next line. And if there is a decrease, then you will say net decrease in working capital. You cannot write both net increase or decrease. You will have to write either of this. Either there will be an increase or there will be a decrease. Correct? So, here we have actually assumed that there is an increase in working capital. That is what the assumption which I have taken in this format. And based on this, we have recorded the difference amount over here. And finally, you will have to take the total. So, once you take the total, you will get the same amount. That means your amount will tally. Now, one thing which is again very important over here is this net increase or decrease in working capital will affect your fund. Correct? So, as we know, if there is an increase in working capital, fund is going out. That means the fund balance which you have will reduce. And if there is a decrease in working capital, fund will increase. So this thing we will have to remember. Increase in working capital, fund goes out. Decrease in working capital, fund comes in. And as we have assumed here as increase in working capital, that means fund is going out. If working capital increases, fund will go out. And as fund goes out, there will be decrease in the fund. Hence, you will have to record the difference of working capital in decrease in working capital column. Now, let me repeat once again why we have recorded in the decrease in working capital column. Because there is a connection between working capital and fund. The moment we are trying to give the effect of working capital, we will have to keep fund in mind. If working capital increases, fund will decrease. Hence, we will have to record the difference of working capital in decrease column. Once you have recorded this, you will have to take the total of both the column, that is increase in working capital as well as decrease in working capital. And it should tally. You will have to ensure that the increase in working capital and decrease in working capital is tallying. That means the total of both the column is getting same. Correct? So I hope you have understood how to prepare the statement of change in working capital. So this is the first step for preparing fund flow statement. Actually, there are four steps. I hope you remember. Step number one, statement of change in working capital, which we have understood just now how to prepare it. Step number 2 is adjusted profit and loss account. Step number 3 is fund flow statement. And step number 4 is we will have to open all the ledger account on which there is an adjustment. So now let us try to understand how to prepare the second step, that is adjusted profit and loss account. So this is how we will have to prepare adjusted profit and loss account. It is very much similar to the profit and loss account. You will have to prepare the account in T form. You will have debit side and credit side. And all the expenses you will have to record on the debit side, and all the income you will have to record in the credit side. Very much similar to profit and loss account, but we are not preparing this to know the profit. Then why we are preparing this? We are preparing this to know the fund generated from operation. Why we are trying to find out fund generated from operation? Because in the next step, we will have to prepare fund flow statement. So in fund flow statement, we record all the sources of fund and all the application of fund, where we have utilized or where we have used this fund. So here, this is again one of the source of the fund. Fund from operation or fund generated from operation is one of the source of fund which will have to transfer in the fund flow statement. And this is the reason we prepare adjusted profit and loss account. So there is not much explanation for adjusted profit and loss account. You can see on the debit side, we have expenses like depreciation, reserves, loss on sale of fixed asset, proposed dividend, provision for taxation. So all the items which we generally take in the profit and loss account debit side, we will have to record here. And credit, in the credit side, you can see profit on sale of fixed asset, dividend received, commission received, and so on. So once you close this account, you will get balance either on the debit side or on the credit side. If you're getting balance on the debit side, it will be fund lost from operation. And if you're getting balance on the credit side, it will be fund generated from operation. Fund generated from operation is a source, wherein fund lost from operation is an application. Right? So this is how we prepare the second step of fund flow statement. And the next step, third step, is fund flow statement. So let us try to understand how to prepare the fund flow statement. This is how we will have to prepare fund flow statement. Here we will have source and application. All the sources of fund will be recorded here, and all the application of fund will be recorded here. This is very much similar to balance sheet, and that is why towards the end your fund flow statement will tally. That means the total of sources will be same as total of application. So let me repeat my statement once again. This is very much similar to the balance sheet, but it is not a balance sheet. Why this is not a balance sheet? Because this is not as on a particular date. And if you receive dividend, you don't record in the balance sheet. If you pay tax, you don't record in the balance sheet. Dividend paid, you don't record in the balance sheet. What exactly we are trying to find out here? We are trying to find out the flow of fund. During the year, there was a flow in the fund. So that is what we are trying to capture with the help of this fund flow statement.